Hi, my name's Eric Prosher, and you're watching Can TV 21. And today, we're representing Jesse Brown VA, and we have a special guest, Allison Chikos. And she is the chief...
Clinical dietitian.
She's going to introduce herself, but she's going to talk about something that's very special to our VA, very special to our medical center director's heart, the Healthy Teaching Kitchen class. So, Allison, why don't you tell us a little bit about your position and what you do at Jesse Brown VA Medical Center?
Well, thank you. Thank you for having me on tonight. My name is Allison Chikos, and I am a clinical dietitian at Jesse Brown. And something that is pretty fun and unusual about me is that before I was a dietitian, I was a pastry cook at a Michelin star restaurant. So I love butter, I love sugar, I love salt, I'm professionally trained, and I have a devil and angel on my shoulders at all time when it comes to food, because I want my food to taste delicious, but I want it also to be healthy so that I can make sure that I live the healthy lifestyle that I talk to all my veterans about every day.
That's great. So so you know how to make the food taste sweet and tasty?
Delicious.
Delicious? All right. So, and for your viewers that have just joined us, you're watching a live call-in program. So call in if you have any questions. And over the next 25 minutes, we're going to hear a little bit about what Allison is doing to improve the health of our veterans at Jesse Brown VA Medical Center. So that's at 312-738-1060. All right, so what are you doing to improve the health of our veterans?
Yeah, so what is the Healthy Teaching Kitchen? Basically, the way we do it, because different VAs across the country have their own versions of the Healthy Teaching Kitchen, and we started ours in August of 2015, and it's a once-a-month healthy cooking class that is demo-based. So I stand up in front of everybody, and I create the recipes based off of whatever the theme of the month is, and we make the recipes, and we taste them, and we talk about nutrition as we go, and we try to have as much fun as possible and eat good food. So really, though, what I focus on with these recipes is trying to make sure that they fit into your health goals. If you have hypertension, or if you are struggling to lose weight and manage your obesity, or if you're diabetic, what's a way that you can continue eating foods that you love, but maybe in a different way that you hadn't thought about before that will make it fit into your goals a little bit better?
Right. So I know that Jesse Brown has the MOVE program, and that's a weight loss program for our veterans. And are you connected to that program?
Yeah, so we are, in the sense that so many of our veterans do both at the same time. It's really great. My class is offered at 10 a.m., and they come to me, and we cook, and we talk about healthy eating. And then later in the day, for the Thursday group, then they end up going to the MOVE group. And it's a really wonderful community that we've been able to build together to talk about nutrition and healthy eating together.
Wow. And so what are some of the challenges that our veterans have with learning how to cook healthy?
Cook healthy. Well, one of my challenges that I share with the veterans is reducing my sodium intake. One thing that I ever tell everybody when I'm teaching them about low sodium eating with an inpatient or outpatient is beware of the food that you do not make. You don't know how much sodium's in it. And processed food, fast food, quick service restaurants, fine dining restaurants have a lot of salt to make it taste delicious. I know how much salt I used to put in my desserts. And like, you don't even think that there's going to be a lot of salt in there. So creating recipes that fit into your sodium goals is definitely something that takes some practice and getting used to. One of my biggest tips that I love is acidic ingredients. So the more that you can decrease that salt in that recipe, but add in some balsamic vinegar or lemon juice or lime juice, it's going to add a lot of flavor.
Wow. What a great tip. So for those of you that have just joined us at home, we're talking to Allison Chikos. She is a chef, registered dietitian at, chief registered dietitian at Jesse Brown VA Medical Center. And on the overhead here, she's talking about Jesse Brown Medical Center's Healthy Kitchen, Teaching Kitchen. And it's the second Thursday of every month at 10 a.m.
Yeah.
And you can check her out on our Facebook page, where she does live demonstrations. And it sounds like today you're going to do some demonstrations.
Yeah.
And we're going to have our medical center director come in, and you can talk them through making something. So what is that something?
Sounds great. So yes, what's really exciting is that we live stream our Healthy Teaching Kitchen class. Mm-hmm. And so we started doing that about a year ago. If you go to that Facebook page, you can see all the classes we've done in the past year and be a fly on the wall and see what we've been doing and join us in September and share our class with us online and ask questions as we go. What we made last class, we're still in August, was overnight oatmeal in a mason jar. How trendy and cool are these right now? People are pinning it on Pinterest, putting it on Instagram. So I wanted to think of a solution. If you're running late in the morning and you don't have time to make breakfast, what's something quick and healthy on the go that's going to keep you full? And it's very different than an instant pack of oatmeal.
Yes.
Because
you're hungry 5 minutes later after you eat one.
I know, right?
Packs.
And this recipe is packed in fiber, healthy fat, and protein that's going to stay with you.
That's the difference in making.
And I'm not going to make this because I want you guys to see how easy this is. So I'm going to talk you through it. So who's going to volunteer to make it?
Well, why don't we bring on Mr. Magill, our medical center director, special guest.
And now, I know how to use the microwave. That's about all. I'm challenged.
Okay. We're just getting set up. Okay, so the first thing that you want to do is put in your oatmeal in the jar. We have 1/4 cup of steel-cut oats. And we'll clean up our spill. We have stuff to do that. The next thing we're going to do is 1 tablespoon of flaxseed meal. That's ground flaxseed. That's how we get the healthy fats in there. Okay.
The omega-3s.
The omega-3s, exactly. Good for our brain, good for our heart. I love them. Okay. Now what we have here you might think is a little unusual. We have 2 tablespoons of non-fat dry milk powder. What is that? Dietitians talk about it all the time as a healthy way to add calories and protein to a lot of our recipes. And it's going to increase the protein of this recipe so that, again, it's going to keep you full. It's going to give you what you need to start your day. Okay, next ingredient. Well, let's give it a little stir. Okay. Take the spoon. We'll stir up the dry ingredients a little bit. Okay, now we want to put in our wet ingredients. Okay, go slow with this one. Okay, we have... Pour it on the corner. Okay. 1/4 cup plus 2 tablespoons of almond milk. Now, we are creating this recipe for a mostly shelf-stable ingredient class. If you wanted to do this with cow milk or soy milk or other milk, that's totally up to you. You can give it a little stir. Okay. Now, we want to sweeten it a little bit. Okay. So, we've got 2 teaspoons of maple syrup. And then our peanut butter flavor, we got to take the spoon out and scoop it out.
Now, is this any type of peanut butter I will do?
You know, smooth, not...
creamy?
Yes, exactly. Not all peanut butters are created equal. Mm-hmm. You want to choose the find the kind that doesn't have any trans fat in it. The less ingredients, the better. But chunky or smooth, that's totally up to you.
Okay, no trans fat.
And that's
less
it.
Ingredients
we stirred it all up, and now we put it in the refrigerator, and we go to sleep.
Oh.
And then I think we're good. We can put lid on.
Okay.
Put the lid on.
That was easy.
Yeah.
And how long?
8 hours.
8 hours?
Yeah. And then magic TV overnight. Do, 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 do. We have our 8-hour version. See how much thicker that is?
I made that?
You made that.
I made that.
You made that.
Okay, I can eat it.
You can eat it. No, so we've got a fresh spoon for you here.
All right.
I'm going to pop off the, just pull it off. There you go.
On live TV.
Okay, give it a little stir.
Okay.
And it's peanut butter. You don't have a peanut butter allergy, do you?
No, I don't.
Okay, I was going to say, I'm pretty sure I've given you peanut butter before.
Yes.
Okay, so you're going to take a bite and tell everyone how delicious this is.
Mmm.
So with the steel-cut oats, it's going to be unusual texture. It's going to be crunchy, kind of like grape nuts. It's going to surprise you a little bit. Now, if you like a creamy texture that's more similar to rolled oats, regular oatmeal, you can use rolled oats. You just want to put a little more milk in. And we have this recipe on our Facebook page. So if you go to that link, we posted it just a couple weeks ago, you'll find it. Now, one thing, before you take another bite, if you want... I have some fresh cut strawberries here.
And the recipe is on your
to make it like peanut butter jelly.
Home is at www.facebook.com.
As much as you want. Okay.
Well, I'm going to go eat this and enjoy. Thank you.
Okay.
Very good.
Well, thank you.
Do you have any questions, Mr. Magill?
I highly recommend.
All right.
Okay. One thing before we transition off of that, thank you so much for your participation, Mr. Magill. Now, something I've learned about working at the VA is the importance of challenge coins with our military. So in the Healthy Teaching Kitchen, we don't have challenge coins, but we have Sergeant Freddie Nutri-Bear badge, and I wanted to thank you. You've earned this, and I also have a hat for you if you ever want to be sous chef at Healthy Teaching Kitchen.
Well, come around.
Right? Turn it's backwards.
Look at the camera.
Okay.
Neil. All
right. Perfect.
Show the badge.
And your pin.
Very good. I will wear it proudly.
All right. Thank you. We're always welcome back in class.
Excellent. Thank you.
Wow. Well, thank you. That was quite a demonstration. Something that's very simple for a veteran to take the meal on the go and get their protein and feel full in the process.
Definitely really easy. And part of what we do in the Healthy Teaching Kitchen class is we use food pantry ingredients from Jesse Brown as inspiration. And so the inspiration here was the oatmeal and the peanut butter. So again, it doesn't have to be steel cut. You can use rolled oats. And then the peanut butter is a great ingredient that our food pantry has a lot. So that's what we were putting together there. And for those of you who are not aware, Jesse Brown has a food pantry every Tuesday, and it opens at 11.
Every Tuesday at 820 South Damon Avenue. Come on down at 11 o'clock. You might come early to get in line. And it sounds like we have a caller. Hello, caller. What is your question? You're here with Allison at the Healthy Teaching Kitchen class.
My husband has a gluten allergy. Can he eat those oats, or is there something else he can have?
That is a great question. Now, it depends. Some oats are processing facilities that you... couldn't risk cross-contamination. So those you would definitely not want to have. Some are processing facilities that are strictly clean of gluten products, and potentially you can have those. But if we didn't have oats at all, that's a really good question. What would you use? You could do, there's a brown rice hot cereal, but I would make it in a hot version and then eat it cold, if that sounds a little unusual. But it would totally work. So you would cook it on the stove, same ingredients, but instead of the oats, try one of those rice cereals. I think it would be kind of interesting with the peanut butter flavor.
Great.
Also, another idea, too, I wanted to point out is anybody who's lactose intolerant can still do this recipe.
This is for the vegans out there.
So what I would do is I would take out the milk powder, which is something that obviously I want in there for extra protein. And so what am I going to replace it with? I'm going to replace it with peanut butter powder. I'm making peanut butter oatmeal. We can make it more peanut butter.
Well, it's a double peanut butter pack.
Yeah. And on one other way you can change this recipe just a little bit too, if you want, is instead of the flax seeds, you can use chia seeds, which are those little tiny black seeds. Mm-hmm. And they swell up, and they are a great source of omega-3s as well.
Great. Wow. Well, it sounds like we have another caller. So, hello, caller. You're watching... the Healthy Teaching Kitchen, brought to you by Jesse Brown VA, and we have registered dietitian Allison Chikos. What is your question?
Hi, I have a question. How do veterans get involved in the Healthy Teaching Cooking class? Sounds like it might be a wonderful opportunity to learn hands-on.
Yeah, so we take walk-ins. It's 10 a.m. the second Thursday of every month, and it's on the third floor of the Damon Building. I post signs up all around, and You literally just come, show up, say, hello, I'm here. It's a demo-based class. We don't do a lot of hands-on. I try to get it when I can. With the location that we're at, it's a really big demo cart, and it's mostly me up there showing you how you taste it along the way, you ask questions along the way. We talk about knife skills and food safety also. So it's a really kind of fun way to all learn together. And we try to keep it as veteran-centered as possible. I want to teach you what you want to learn. So we take suggestions at the end of every single class of what foods you want to learn, what types of cuisine. And based off of that, we incorporate that into the next classes as soon as we can. I had a request for African dishes. So we did an African sweet potato stew last month, which was great because we were able to incorporate a veteran request and the food pantry at the same time.
Great. What a great question. Again, that's the second Thursday of every month at 10 a.m. And you can check us out on Facebook for further information right there at home, facebook.com/VA Chicago. Now, Allison, what are some of the favorite recipes that veterans have noted since you've been doing this?
Oh, man. Probably the most liked recipe is the hummus recipe. That was made at, so that was made by a veteran request, and we have viewers out there nodding saying yes, they agree. But it's very simple. You do need a food processor. You can use a mini one, a big one, doesn't have to be fancy. You can get a small one at Target, different kind of large stores all over. And so you blend up chickpeas with a few other ingredients, doesn't take very much, and we eat it fresh, and they can see how simple it is.
Great. So we have a few minutes left. I'm Eric Prosher. This is Allison Chikos. We're from Jesse Brown VA Medical Center. We want you to come check out our healthy teaching kitchen class, our food pantry, and for veterans out there, you should also know that we have the Veteran Crisis Line. If you need to talk to someone at any point, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, you call 1-800-273-TALK and hit 1 for veterans. And check us out on Facebook. As I noted, we're going to be back here on the fourth Thursday of every month at 6:30. And Allison and Mr. Magill, also I wanted to thank you for coming on the show and sharing us your great ideas. And it looks like we do have time for one more phone call, and so we're going to take a call. Hello, caller. What is your question? You're here with Allison.
I would like to know if the breakfast oatmeal that you just demonstrated is good for someone who's trying to lose weight.
Yes, definitely. So let me grab my cheat for a second here. The recipe... Okay, so it is a heavy-duty recipe. It's not a light-calorie, low-calorie food. It's 400 calories in one serving. But if you are trying to lose weight and this is something that's going to keep you full and this is your meal, it can definitely help you in that way. And it's going to fill you with those healthy fats and healthy sources of fiber that are going to be good for your blood cholesterol as well.
Well, that sounds great. Then maybe I won't want to continue to eat throughout the whole morning. Thank you.
It can be hard, but then this one will definitely help kind of curb that snacking craving.
Thank you.
The idea
can't wait to try it.
The idea is that you'll be full throughout the day.
Exactly.
And you won't want a snack after you have one serving, which is 400 calories.
So I have a question for you.
Okay.
What is your favorite healthy food? Healthy meal, healthy snack, healthy anything?
That is a good question. I've struggled with, I was a vegan for 26 years and, I keep reading different things about science and somewhere along the line I got the idea like, well, maybe I should include more protein in my diet and try seafood or meat again. And then, so I'm in this kind of in-between phase where I'm trying to figure out what's best. Because I also noticed that, like, I like scrambled tofu, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's weird how your taste buds change, because I used to like eggs, but I haven't had eggs in 26 years. And now the thought of eating eggs is strange to me. But again, the science on the eggs has changed too. A lot of people are saying eggs are one of the healthiest things you can eat now, right?
They're delicious. I love eating eggs. Mm-hmm. But my favorite healthy food is roasted Brussels sprouts. I've met a lot of people over the years who tell me they don't like vegetables, they won't eat vegetables, but they haven't learned how to cook them so that they're extra delicious.
Yes.
And the way that I do it is a really high temperature in the oven, like 400, and then the natural sugars in there caramelize. And it's like candy Brussels sprouts, but it's just the vegetable and a tiny bit of salt and olive oil.
I've had them. They're quite delicious.
Do you have a favorite guilty pleasure food? We are our own pastry chef.
Right. cranberry bars.
Healthy eater. You never splurge.
That's my splurge.
That's impressive. Mine's s'mores.
S'mores?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You know, every once in a while in the summer.
All right. Well, it looks like we have to wrap it up. Again, my name's Eric Prosher, and I'll be here next month. And I want to thank Allison Chikos and Mr. Magill for joining us to talk about what Jesse Brown VA is doing to improve the meals and the recipes of our veterans. And you can learn more about our organization by checking us out on Facebook, www.facebook.com/VA Chicago. And please stay tuned for the hosts to follow us. And goodbye for now.